Have you ever touched the inside of your aquarium glass or maybe the hardscape and felt a slimy texture? Well, that slimy texture is biofilm, and it's a crucial component to your aquarium's ecosystem. So what exactly is biofilm, and why is it so important for having a healthy and stable shrimp tank? Let's dive right in. Biofilm is an underrated, largely invisible to the naked eye, natural food that shrimp love to eat. If you have snails, Otocinclus catfish, or Hillstream loaches in your aquarium, they too feast on biofilm. Biofilm is made up of various bacteria, algae, and fungi. These tiny microorganisms produce a clear slime that helps them grip to the aquarium glass, hardscape, plants, and substrate. This slime is what makes up the majority of your shrimp's diet, which is why it's a crucial component to your aquarium's ecosystem. When setting up a new tank, you'll want to give it a few weeks to cycle, but during that period, biofilm will also start forming. Having a large amount of biofilm growing in your tank is a great indicator of your tank's health and is a very positive sign. It's important to note that just because you may have lots of biofilm, it doesn't mean your tank is cycled. You should still test your water parameters before adding any shrimp. Also, adding shrimp too early to a tank that does not have biofilm can cause them to starve, forcing you to supplement their diet with food that could possibly lead to ammonia and nitrite spikes. Biofilm does not need light to grow, just nutrients in the water. At normal levels, you won't really be able to see it, but once it's accumulated a thick layer, it might look slightly translucent or a cloudy jelly. If you see your shrimp constantly grazing throughout the day, then it's a good sign that you have a healthy supply in your tank. Tanks with a rich supply of biofilm usually have the best success with breeding. So how do you grow biofilm? Well, there are a few ways you can do so, but you do not need to implement them all. By implementing one or some of these methods, it guarantees that biofilm should start forming in a few days, but it can take a few weeks to build up to a useful quantity. The first method is using powdered foods. Usually, when I'm starting a new tank, I will ghost feed it with powdered foods every few days for a couple of weeks. Ghost feeding means that I'm feeding a tank without any inhabitants. The filter will push the particles all over the tank, and as they break down, those tiny microorganisms that make up biofilm will feast on the nutrients and start multiplying. Some of the powdered foods I use are fish flakes that I crush up and grind down into a powder form using my mortar, but if you have a coffee grinder, you can use that too. I also use Bacteriae, Shrimp Baby, and Shrimp Fit, which are micropowders. If you'd like to learn more about these products, check out the video in the top right corner. If you're interested in purchasing any of these products, you can visit my Amazon store, which I've linked in the description below. Feeding powdered foods does not need to be done only when starting a new tank. You can continue doing so once your tank is established and you've got shrimp in there. The second method is feeding more. This basically means providing your shrimp with enough food to supplement their diet, but also having a little extra in there to break down to help form more biofilm. If you're not careful and do this too often, it can lead to overfeeding, which can have a negative effect on your water parameters. Your ammonia, nitrite, and nitrate levels could increase when food starts to rot, and those compounds, especially low levels of ammonia and nitrite, are toxic to shrimp. You'll definitely want to experiment to find the right balance, but if you're unsure, you can always add snails to your tank, and they will be able to break down excess food a lot faster before it becomes a problem. The third method is adding leaf litter and botanicals to your tank. This can be in the form of Indian almond leaves, mulberry leaves, oak leaves, and alder cones, to name a few. Leaf litter and botanicals provide massive amounts of surface area for biofilm to form on, and as they break down in the tank, the nutrients will allow for even more biofilm to form. However, adding excessive leaf litter or botanicals may lower your water's pH, which can adversely affect your shrimp due to their sensitivity to changes. Your water may also darken due to the released tannins, but there's no need to worry. Water changes will fix this if it's an issue for you. Tannins themselves have long been considered to have health benefits for shrimp due to their antibacterial and antifungal properties. The fourth method is adding more plants and hardscape to your tank. Just like with leaf litter, adding more plants and hardscape simply gives the microorganisms more room to grow and build a sizable population. Driftwood, chola wood, lava rock, and java moss, to name a few, are some popular choices among shrimp keepers and aquarists alike. And finally, the fifth method is to leave your substrate and aquarium glass alone. Biofilm will grow everywhere given enough time. Frequently cleaning your aquarium glass and vacuuming your substrate will slow down this growth. As excess food and shrimp waste break down, they release nutrients which these microorganisms love. When gravel vacuuming, you're removing their food source and sucking up any biofilm that has already formed. If you wish to clean the glass, clean the front panel only so that you can always have a nice view of what's going on in your tank. Leave the back and side panels alone for biofilm to form on, which in turn will provide a valuable source of food for your shrimp. With biofilm being a free food source that grows by itself, and while it may contain microorganisms that are generally very safe, there are some risks if you're not careful. Just like your shrimp, these microorganisms also consume oxygen. This is why you need to be careful when feeding bacteria-promoting powdered foods like bacteria E, shrimp baby, and shrimp fit, because excessive amounts can potentially suffocate your shrimp of oxygen, resulting in the loss of your colony. As I mentioned this, I wonder if it could be one of the factors contributing to the deaths in my red cherry shrimp tank. If you haven't seen the video, you can check it out in the top right corner. Fortunately, this can be dealt with by adding an air stone in the tank. The surface agitation will help break up any biofilm that might be on the surface of the water, allowing for oxygen to enter and carbon dioxide to leave the tank. If you find yourself needing to reduce the amount of biofilm in your tank, you can scrape the glass and gravel vacuum the substrate to remove excess biofilm. Additionally, consider stopping the use of powdered foods and switching to solid options like algae wafers or pellets, or removing excess leaf litter and botanicals. In conclusion, understanding the significance of biofilm in your shrimp tank is crucial for maintaining a healthy ecosystem. Biofilm serves as a natural food source for your shrimp, aiding in their nutrition and overall well-being. However, it's essential to be mindful of potential risks associated with biofilm, such as oxygen depletion when using bacteria-promoting powdered foods. Thankfully, there are various methods to manage biofilm levels, from adding leaf litter and botanicals to introducing more plants and hardscape elements. Additionally, maintaining proper tank maintenance practices, such as occasional glass cleaning and substrate vacuuming, can help regulate biofilm growth. By finding a balance and staying attentive to your tank's dynamics, you can create a thriving environment for your shrimp while minimizing potential risks. If you'd like to create a planted tank for your shrimp, check out the following videos. They're packed with valuable tips and insights that I'm sure you'll find useful. Additionally, if you enjoyed this video and want to further support this channel, you can follow me on Patreon. I regularly share additional content there for both free and paid members. Your subscription to this channel also means a lot to me. I'm Andy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.